Hello?
Well, good morning. My name is Adam Smith, calling from NobelPrize.org. Congratulations on the award of the Nobel Prize.
Oh, thanks. Thanks.
And
we've got multiple phones in the room running. My wife's going to get the other one.
Yes. You're going to be bombarded from this point on.
This is crazy. I just told somebody I'm not quite sure how I'm going to get through the day. I need to replicate myself.
But it almost seem a little unreal, having not actually heard from the committee. So you're hearing it secondhand, so to speak.
I don't know. Somehow, it's just all spinning around in my head that this has happened. You know about these things, and you can see possibilities on the horizon, but you never really. Has this really happened? I'm still at that stage.
It's hard to remember how things were 30 years ago. And nowadays, the idea of linking genes with behavior is sort of, people expect that. But then it was a very pioneering thing to do.
Oh, yeah. I mean, this was, I had gone to Stanford to learn how to use this technology. It was brand new in the 70s. And starting up my lab at Rockefeller, I had worked a little bit on this problem, circadian rhythms, thanks to these tremendous mutants that Seymour Benzer and his student Ron Kanapka had found. And I just thought it was a terrific problem and maybe the toughest thing I could try to tackle because it was behavior. What could we learn about a fairly complicated behavior that we all exhibit? Which was, most easily represented by sleep-wake cycles. And frankly, I thought we'd find out maybe a little bit. I never thought we would really understand what the motor behind this was at the time. We were very lucky. We managed to find genes that fit together like puzzle pieces to explain how this thing worked. And the techniques and the approaches kept changing. And I was very lucky. I kept getting students and postdocs that were extremely good and just did everything right. And the other piece of this was, it was a sort of a race going on in the early years. My colleagues, Jeff Hall and Michael Rostash, and we kind of pushed each other along because, I mean, most of it was independently done, but we did it to collaborate from time to time, but we worked on slightly different problems, but the solutions to those problems all, as I was saying, fit together like puzzle pieces to kind of bring the picture into view. It's been really quite satisfying. This is, this really pushes it way, way over the top. It's really quite incredible.
Yeah.
And I couldn't, this is terribly exciting, as you can imagine.
You do sound wonderfully amazed. It's very nice to hear.
Oh, I am. I'm just, like I think I said, I'm just wondering how I'm going to get through the day.
Will we be seeing you in Stockholm in December?
Well, of course. Are you kidding? I'll be there.